Jay Randall is the starter. Kemba, the finisher. Jay Randall is the facilitator. Kemba more of a narrator. Jay Randall needed a closer. Kemba's here to close. Question, who is the most important weapon on the Knicks bench?
I think this is going to be a really interesting second year for Quick. Mm-hmm. He talked about a guy that got bigger.
Yeah.
I mean, he's definitely been in the gym.
The gun show out.
Shoulders got bigger, and so a little more confidence there physically for him. But I just feel like a guy like that, if he can add the facilitating to his game, I just feel like there's that Lou Williams vibe mm-hmm. that I think he'll buy into. I really do. I'm not trying to pigeonhole him. I'm not trying to put him in a box. But there are some guys that just have a game, and you watch him. He's going to be that.
Yeah.
And once he buys into that, which I think he can, that's the weapon. Like, he can be a weapon.
Yeah, I'm with you, man. I'm going Quick. We know the shooting is already elite, and we talked about this on previous shows about what we'd like to see him work on in terms of his game. As you said, facilitating is one. Seems like that was a point of emphasis even in summer league. You know, after each game, first person to speak to him was Tibbs. Tibbs was in his ear, and you know he's instructing him about the plays that he missed, obviously, whether it's on offense or defense. But I also think, how does he navigate in the intermediate range? You know, there was a stat. He only shot about 15 mid-range jumpers. He's relying on the floater to get to the hoop. Doesn't really finish at the rim fairly well. And also, he's going to have to navigate the new rules in the NBA. That's going to limit some of those creative fouls that he was able to draw, especially earlier on in his rookie year. They didn't really give him that respect later on and in the playoffs, and also thought teams adjusted well to what he was trying to do in terms of drawing the contact. But I want to see how he operates in the mid-range as teams try to run him off that three-point line. And so that's where he's going to have to be better as a facilitator, and then see, you know, is there another go-to move that he has to get some high percentage shots at the rim.
Yeah, getting to the free throw line was special because he was good at the, you know, the fender bender fouls where he just stopped short, you run into him, right? Like that's something I wonder if he'll still be able to pull off. But he is still pretty good with the sleight of hand. He's a very crafty player. I do think he's got a very high IQ. His also confidence level is irrationally high, mm-hmm. which I respect that. I respect that. Like I think that's okay. I'd rather dial back your confidence and be a player that I'm trying to build up your confidence.
Yeah,
it's so much easier to dial you back.
True.
That's what I like about him. Now, again, you know, we glazed over another obvious, you know, key weapon off the bench. It's Derrick Rose.
Derrick Rose, for sure.
And he was their best player against the Hawks, right? Mm-hmm. Can we say? Like, he was the best player for the Knicks in that series.
No question.
And you could tell the Hawks were scared of him. Like, they worried about him. And I wonder with Kemba, does it make Derrick better? Does that make sense? Because you don't have to change the way you play.
Yeah.
When Kemba comes out, Derek comes in. It's kind of the same thing, right? Mm-hmm. Guy creates for himself, can get into the paint, can make things happen. You know, both guys, you know, are creative players. I think both are fairly good three-point shooters. Derek became a pretty good three-point shooter by the end of the year.
Very efficient.
Yeah, and I just feel like if you're keeping him in the 20s in his minutes, and we know he's taking care of his body much different even now than he did early in his career after the injuries. He's really become a guy that's he's got such a mature game, you know, in his prep, in his awareness. I think where he is right now mentally, all that stuff. And I wonder, like, with a full year now with the Knicks, with already that, you know, the half year under his belt and the role that is defined for him, you know, he got votes for sixth man. I mean, he was a finalist. I think he should always be in the conversation for the rest of his career. Because of the type of game he's got. He's still got game. You just can't, you know, you're just not going to get high mileage out of him anymore. But with Kemba, you don't really need to.
The Rose Hive. I've been saying that all year, huh? The Rose Hive, they're so sensitive to that. They're even more sensitive than the Nilakina Hive. Let me tell you, the Rose Hive, they'll go watch his 2011, you know, MVP highlights and then come back and tell you how wrong you are about him. I've been saying it from the time he got here. You got to manage the minutes correctly. It's the reason why they went and got Kemba. You know, you have to manage him correctly. And the Rose Hive is like, you're wrong. He's our guy. He can start. He can close. He can do this. He can do that. He can do 30 minutes.
Can
this,
he
that,
start? Third.
No, but I mean, be a 30-plus minute a night guy starting. That's what I mean by start.
Yeah, not for 82.
Right.
Not for 82. Can I do it in a playoff series? I could. And I think they tried to. Mm-hmm. But I think even he knows, just physically managing himself. And that's where I wonder if, you know, Grimes, McBride, if those guys can get some burn, it will be because on a given night, all right, it's a back-to-back. So Kemba won't play the first night of this one. Derek won't play the second night of this one. And one of the kids will kind of fill in the blanks.
That's what I thought.
So if need be, and then you're good. You know, like, I just feel like, why not do that? Why not just to make sure that Kemba just, it's okay. He doesn't have to play every game, but I'd rather manage him that way and manage Derek that way, knowing I'll have them. They're, you know, like, their batteries won't drain as much if I use them, you know, just enough. Like, just enough, and then let them recharge. Just enough, let them recharge. There's no reason to really drive them too much too soon.
Yeah.
And I think that's the value of having two of these guys on the roster. Again, you know, Kemba was not somebody that was in the plans. Kemba was somebody that became available to them, and it was like, all right, it's pretty cheap. Let's do it. Mm-hmm. Like, let's do it and hope that the time off and him having a full off season, we can really focus and get his health right. Let's hope that whatever was ailing him, that knee and the issues that he's had all last year with Boston, hope it's behind him. But we can't believe it is, right? So if he starts dealing with knee issues by Thanksgiving, Derek's got to start. He's got to start. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, can he log those minutes? I think he can. It's not optimal to ask him to if he doesn't need.
Yeah, that's how I feel. And to the metaphor orator's question, I said quickly because I feel like you know what you're going to get from Rose and you can count on him. And it was great. What he gave us was great. You know, big X factor for us to make the playoffs. With Burks, I think you know what you're going to get as well. You're going to get a erratic scorer, but a bucket still. And a guy that could get it going for you in spurts. And I think that's who he is. But with IQ, if he can, you know, we already know shooting is elite. Shot 40% from three. If he can take it up a notch, whether as a facilitator or in the intermediate, then I think, you know, that's really going to give us a lift. Because that trio, that bench unit was already tops in the league. But I think if IQ can you know, evolve in that way, it's really going to be solid.
Think about what you saw in the summer league, him and Obi.
Yeah, like, chemistry was there, man.
But, you know, one thing we take for granted is Quick's handle. I actually think it's pretty tight. Like, I didn't know, like, you know, he does have it enough where if you put pressure on him, he's good. Like, he's not a guy that gets a little rattled, like, put pressure on me, I'm going to turn the ball over, I got to get rid of it because I can't dribble. Mm-hmm. Like, he's got a pretty tight handle, but, he wants to push. And, you know, Obi wants to run. And, you know, that's also something with the second unit that I'm curious to see as well. Is like, Obi might not get a ton of minutes, but they could be pretty exciting minutes with the two of them together. That summer league was important for those two.
Big time.
Because they didn't have one time. And when you are out of your first year, the one thing you're supposed to do is go to summer league, dominate.
Yeah.
Like rookies coming off their rookie season go to summer league, and you're supposed to go there and you're supposed to own everyone. And they did. I mean, they did that. I mean, neither guy looked overwhelmed.
Yeah,
and that was important to show. And when people say, "What's the big deal?" Exhibit A, Kevin Knox. That's it. This Exhibit A, Kevin Knox. His second year, coming off his rookie year, he went in and Zion just dominated. Oof.
That was a tough game to be at, man.
Yeah, I know.
So
not everybody comes in after year two and dominates summer league. It doesn't always happen. So. You know, that's why I felt like this summer league was very important and why, you know, Quick is definitely a guy I got my eyes on off the bench.